Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. It has been a while. My apologies. Work and life has been getting in the way, but I wanted to get it out. I had an Instagram message from Paul today, one of the channel viewers, and he's like, he asked me, number one, where are you? I'm busy with work. Sorry about that, everybody. But he also mentioned, he's like, you forgot about the Fuji firmware update fix. So I wanted to get it out there to everybody, let them know there is a fix for the Fuji X-T4 and the X-Pro3 and the X-E4 that came out. There was an issue with the X-T4 in particular, I know on the channel, where it was freezing up with that latest update, and it was something to do with the pairing registration and the Bluetooth on your camera. There was a fix that Fuji posted. I posted that in my last video on how to change your pairing settings to avoid that problem. Now, Fuji has actually released a new firmware update that apparently addresses this problem. What I have been kind of reading though in the forums very quickly is some cameras, I wouldn't necessarily recommend you updating to this firmware if you are experiencing no issues with your camera. It seems like a really kind of incremental update. And if you're not, I'm kind of under the impression if your camera's not broken, don't try and fix it. So if that problem was happening and you managed to fix it with that change in settings, keep your camera as it is. If for some reason it's still not working and freezing and you have to take out the battery, maybe try doing this update. But if everything's working fine, from what I've kind of read and the gist, it's kind of an incremental thing. I wouldn't bother updating to your camera. It's only kind of fixing that one problem. And there's always, as always with firmware, when one comes out, some new problems kind of surface up. And what Paul had messaged me saying that he has read on some forums that it was actually stopping some cameras from actually working. So as always, kind of maybe beware. You might maybe want to hold off on updating on this firmware update if everything in your cameras are working fine. If you do want to update and check it out, I will leave all the links in the description below so you can see the firmware update and go download it from Fuji website. As always, I recommend doing the update manually through an SD card and not using the Fuji app, because the Fuji app is very flaky with its connection, especially now because your camera probably Bluetooth and all that connection is probably off. So thanks for watching, everybody. We will be back soon with some more POV videos, some more Fuji recipe videos. I do have the Kodachrome 2 simulation loaded on my camera. I just haven't really had a chance to get outside and take many pictures. Plus, we're kind of in the middle of fire season here, so it has been super smoky outside. So to get outside and walk around is not the greatest if you can avoid going outside. I kind of avoid going outside, but we will get more photos soon. I want to really tie that Kodachrome, but on a nice, bright, sunny day. So thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.